He thought there was nothing more to life than study.
Yes,
until
awesome.
One day, when he had a message.
Hey man, have you heard about the new University Starly?
University Starly? What's that?
It's a new league in StarCraft 2 for all university students in Stockholm.
Boy! But I'm not really that good.
It doesn't matter.
Will there be beer?
Of course there will be beer.
And where will it be
it's
held?
It's gonna be held at KDH.
KDH? I gotta go check this thing out.
And so he did. The very next day, he went to KTH to meet the crew and see where the finals would be held.
It's incredible!
He had to start exploring right away.
This is the bar. This is where the bar craft will be. So much room for casual gaming! This has to be where the main event is going to be. I wonder what it will look like.
In his mind, he envisioned the final event.
People say, Walling, that's a Zerg. How do you do that? Well, just place a few evolution chambers.
This is gonna be amazing!
But something interrupted his dreaming.
There you are. Come on, let me show you the crew.
Oh, super!
Welcome to the office.
He followed Douglas, the project manager, into the office, and there they all were. There was Lisa, the project coordinator.
Send me the files from yesterday.
Charlie, the lead programmer.
Not now, coding.
Petter, the creative director.
A fluorescent kite.
No.
Marco, the documentations officer.
Oh, hello.
Aaron and Elin, communications officer and public relations.
Can you hold the baby? I have to tweet.
No, I'm making money here.
And Gustav.
My internet's down again.
The slightly eccentric IT manager.
Ethernet cable!
Thank you!
There you go!
Together, they are the crew for University Star League. The league that cares about gaming. About StarCraft. About students. But most of all, they care about you. University Star League.
So much room for casual gaming!
All right, we're in here with the winner's interview, and these guys have gone started chatting already, but I'm going to interrupt that so that we can hear it all. You were asking, what did you think about doing more Sentry Mortal pushes?
No, because it's a show match. I thought it would be boring for the audience to see.
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? Give it up for Manor Proxy Panda, right? Yeah.
Thank you.
What would you have said about more Sentry Immortal pushes? Can you hold those?
Well, I can hold them sometimes. I've been working on this Hydra kind of thingy, but I took my gas too late. That's why I had so few Hydras when he did the push. Because usually if you kill the probe and then you can micro against the warp prism, you can slow the push down really hard and then use Hydras. But I haven't been optimizing it yet, so it's not that good of an answer.
Well, it looked really cool, and we liked it. We liked it. Swade was very happy to see Hydras. I was very happy to see Hydras, and you really snapped that warp prism very quickly. That was nice, and you got it with an immortal in it as well, which was very nice. A little bit of a bonus, but yeah, it was a little bit of a funky composition. Too many links with those Hydras and so forth. I'm thinking that that was the gas problem probably. Yeah. So, what were you thinking through game two when you were down two games already?
Game two when I was done. Game three. Yep. I was thinking, all right, I hope this guy doesn't do this Immortal Sentry all in again. And if I pick a Metropolis, maybe he will play a more macro standard style. Yeah. And actually, just before the Warp Prism came into my base, I was thinking, all right, if I have Overlords here and here, I will see the Warp Prism. It will be no problem. And then I saw it in my base because I was slow for some reason. And I was like,
I saw the expression. I glanced over there and I saw very stressed out Fubar just handling the situation. And you pulled your workers off from the natural a few times there as well, up against the force fields. Were you wanting from them to go out, or what were you doing?
Now, the problem was I was control clicking the workers in the main, and my screen was a little bit too much towards the natural, so I was selecting those two. Yeah, exactly.
But you really you got a nice push right back, and you did so much damage in the natural, which, well, basically threw the game in the other way, other direction. Just a quick question. This whole thing with researching hallucination Then building a war prism, flying it past overlords, then dropping one sentry, hallucinating a war prism, flying in with that to dupe the player to pull all his forces there, and then fly into the natural, I guess, and force field a ramp. How often does that work?
I haven't tried it so much. It was a special build for today, but I had hope for this one group syndrome, you know, everything and right click on the war prism, but Huber was evidently too smart for that. Yeah.
You were thinking about the mathematical part here, because you had split your forces. You figured out that... Did you figure this out?
I didn't figure out that it was a hallucination. Probably I just didn't look when he did the actual hallucinations. That was kind of newbie of me. Yeah. But usually when they do the war prism harass, they can't have that many units anyway. So if you split up your units in the right areas, it's no problem.
Yeah, of course. Well, just master's level mechanics smashing that. All right, guys. You have a special gift. Do you want to take it from here?
Yeah, thank you. So, actually, I'm happy that the cheeky player lost. It's always fun when that happens, right? So, here's my little panda for you since you won. Congratulations.
That's nice. That's the kind of manners we want to see here at University Star League. That's what we want to see, and we're going to send more of. Awesome. So, guys... If you think that you can beat either of these players, I don't know how many of these pandas you have, but I'm guessing not so many. That was for the first player to beat you. Yeah. Well, if you think that you can smash any of these two players and the upcoming ones as well, you should come here and you should sign up on our list to challenge them later on this evening. It's right here on this iPad. Don't steal the iPad. Just sign the list. And you can win some nice stuff. These players have both gotten our mouse pads from QPad. And everyone who manages to win a game is going to get a mouse pad as well. And if you do something very, very cool, even if you don't win, you might get one anyway, just for the sake of it. Yeah, you never know. So we're going to take a 10-minute break, and after that we're going to throw ourselves into the player interviews with Motherlisk and Prop Dash. So one awesome best of five coming up. Give it up for that, guys. Yeah. See you people in 10 minutes.